We are currently studying the section in the Ashtadhyayi, which lays down the conditions under which a dvadvaha compound has to be constructed only samahare and not itaretara yoge. Recall that as per the sutram 2229, charthe dvandvaha, a dvandvaha compound may express samaharaha, meaning a group in which the individuality of the terms is subservient to the group, or itaretara yogaha, a group in which the individuality of the terms is evident. But the section from 242 down to 2411 tells us of those situations in which a dvandvaha compound has to express only a samaharaha. We have already studied the two rules 242, dvandvascha prani turya senanganam, and 246, jatira praninam. Let us now take the sutram 249, yeshancha virodha shashvatikaha. Vritti is very simple. It says, yeshan dvandva ekavat. So the meaning of the sutram is, a dvandvaha compound whose terms denote those among whom there is permanent enmity is always singular in number and hence always expresses a samaharaha and not itaretara yogaha. Example here is, ahayascha nakulaschaishau samaharaha equals ahinakulam, a collection of snakes and mongooses. The alaukika vigraha is ahijas plus nakulajas, compounding a force authorized by the sutram 2229 charthe dvandvaha. Now, ahi has a designation ghi by the sutram 147, shesho ghyasakhi, while nakula does not. Not only that, ahi has two syllables, while nakula has three syllables. So, ahi has fewer syllables than nakula. Hence, as for the sutram 2232, dvandve ghi, as well as 2234, alpach taram, ahi jas is placed in the prior position in this dvandvaha compound. Now, ahi jas plus nakula jas gets the designation pratipadikam by 1246 krit tadita samasascha, because we have formed a samasaha. This allows us to apply 2471 supodhatu pratipadikayoho to perform the look elision on the sup affixes jas and jas, which are inside the compound pratipadikam. So now we have ahinakula as the final compound pratipadikam. Since the terms of this dvandvaha compound denote those, that is snakes and mongooses, among whom there is permanent enmity, this compound is always singular in number and hence always expresses a samaharaha, a group in which the individuality of the terms is subservient to the group, as per the present sutram 246. So the conditions for applying the present sutram 246 are satisfied. We have a dvandvaha compound and the terms of this compound expresses those that have permanent enmity among them. The enmity between snakes and mongooses is of course well known. So this compound only expresses a samaharaha. And as per sutram 2417, sanapumsakam, it is neuter in gender. A compound which expresses a samaharaha is always neuter in gender. This compound declines like vana shabdaha. The first note here says that the force of the word cha used in this sutram is that of eva, meaning only. The Siddhanta Kamudi says, go vyagram kako lukam ityadau paratvat vibhasha vriksha mriga trna dhanya vyanjana pashu shakunyashva vadava purva paradharottaranam iti praptam chakarena badhyate. The reference is to the sutram 2412, which is a later sutram in the Ashtadhyayi compared to the present sutram 249. So in the example, gavascha vyagrascha equals go vyagram, a collection of cows and tigers, as well as kakascho lukascha, kakaha cha ulukaha cha equals kako lukam, a collection of crows and owls, the compound would only optionally express a samaharaha as per the later rule 2412. That rule has the mention of Vibhasha, and it includes Pashu and Shakuni in the long list. Vriksha, Mriga, Trina, Dhanya, Vyanjana, Pashu, Shakunyashva, Vadava, Purva, Para, Dharottaranam. Meaning that when the terms of a Dvandvaha compound express any one of these, then that Dvandvaha compound may only optionally express a Samaharaha. It may also express a Itaretara Yogaha. So this 2-4-12 being a later rule, it would normally override the rule 2-4-9 which we are studying right now. So in the example Gavascha Vyagrascha, where we have cows and tigers, names of two animals, and in the example Kakashcholukascha, where we have crows and owls, names of two birds, what would happen is that this Sutram 2-4-12 would override 2-4-9, meaning that even if there is permanent enmity between cows and tigers and crows and owls, the Dvandvaha compound would express a Samaharaha only optionally. But that is not what is seen in the language. That is not what we want. Hence, we deduce that the force of the mention of Cha in the Sutram Yeshan Cha Virodha Shashvatikaha is that of Eva, meaning that if the conditions of the Sutram 2-4-9 are satisfied, it doesn't matter if both the members express names of beasts or birds, the Dvandvaha compound has to be only Samahare. There is no optional form of Itaretara Yoge. So basically the Chakaraha is Punarvidhayakaha. It comes back and again tells us that in spite of the optionality mentioned in 2-4-12, if the members of a Dvandvaha compound denote those among which there is permanent enmity, the Dvandvaha compound has to express only a Samaharaha. The next note says that Shashvatikaha Kim. Why does this sutram contain the condition Shashvatikaha, meaning permanent? Consider the example Devasurair Amrutam Ambunidhir Mamanthe. Devasurai Amrutam Ambunidhi Mamanthe. This is a passive form, meaning that the ocean was churned by the gods and demons for nectar, means for obtaining nectar. This is a dvikarmaka prayogaha. There are two objects, the ocean and nectar. The nectar, of course, is the primary object. That is the main objective of the churning. While ambunidhi, the ocean, is the secondary object, the gauna karma. And its passive construct, the gauna karma, ambunidhi, is abhihitam. If you want to refresh your memory, please go back and look at the Sutram 1451, Akathitancha, where all this is discussed in detail. So in this sentence, Ambunidhi is of course Prathama Ekvachanam, while Amrutam is Vitiya Ekvachanam. Okay, now one may ask, how is the compound Devasuraihi justified? This compound is of course plural, and hence we know it does not express a Samaharaha, it expresses Itaretara Yogaha. Because a compound which expresses a Samaharaha is always Ekavat, singular in number. And here Devasuraihi is obviously plural. And we know that the gods and demons are opposed to each other. So how come the present Sutram 2-4-9 did not apply here? The answer is that the enmity between the Devaha, the gods, and the Asuraha, the demons, is not permanent. Sutram 2-4-9 specifically mentions Shashvatikaha. The enmity has to be permanent. Even though the gods and demons are opposed on most occasions, at the time of the churning of the ocean, they cooperated. There was no opposition in that action. And hence the enmity is not permanent, and therefore Taretara Yogaha is also allowed. This example highlights the importance of the condition Shashvatikaha, meaning permanent. If that condition is not satisfied, then the Dvandvaha compound does not have to be only Samahare.